Rebecca, you're about to be married. How does it feel?
I am super excited. Things have been chaotic the last couple days, but everything's really come together this afternoon, and I'm so excited.
So everybody here knows me as Mo. My full name is Mariah. I actually don't know Rebecca as well as everybody else here, but I know I've known Jesse for close to 20 years, and I have never seen Jesse this. I would go as far to say giddy, like around her and with this relationship, and it makes my heart so happy to see them together. And I absolutely adore that I've been able to develop a relationship with Rebecca. And I swear I'm not gonna start crying, but the connection that they have and me being included in this and meeting everybody and so many amazing people and being in this makes it just, I love every bit of it.
I am absolutely so happy that Jesse and Rebecca are getting married today. They are absolutely the perfect couple. I don't think Jesse or Rebecca could find anybody better besides themselves. So I am very excited and can't wait for a great night.
I'm Diane, and I've known Rebecca for a very long time. I met her through a poker league. And then when I met Jesse, he just came off on me as a good guy for her. I've seen her through her worst, and he makes her happy. And I'm very happy that they're getting married, and I love them both.
Hi, I'm Felicia. I'm Rebecca's sister. I'm extremely excited for both of them tonight. All we've ever wanted for Becky is to find someone to love her the way that we do. And we couldn't ask for anybody better than Jesse for her.
Hi, I'm Gio, and I've seen Rebecca at poker lots of times. And I'm glad that she's getting married.
My name is Serenity. And I love that they're getting married because they are best friends.
I'm Alex, and I'm very excited for them to get married.
Jesse,
yeah.
You're about to be married.
I am.
How does it feel?
Pretty awesome. I mean, it's fantastic. I could keep talking about it forever if you want.
Doing so. are gathered here today to celebrate the marriage of Rebecca and Jesse. We come together not to mark the start of a relationship, but to recognize a bond that already exists. This ceremony is a public affirmation of that bond. Jesse and Rebecca, you have come here today from your varied life experiences to make public the commitment you have made to each other. You combine your two separate lives into one, although sharing one life, never forget that you are two separate people. Cherish and affirm your differences. Love each other. Keep your commitment foremost in the hearts and minds. Jesse and Rebecca, the ceremony of marriage in which you come to be united is one of the first and oldest ceremonies in the world. Marriage is a gift that we give ourselves totally to one another. I believe that marriage is a gift given to comfort the sorrows of life and to magnify life's joys. Marriage is the clasping of hands, the blending of two hearts, the union of two lives into one, and your marriage must stand, not by the authority of the state nor the seal of your wedding certificate, but by the strength and power of the love you have for one another. Jesse and Rebecca, your new partnership begins as you proclaim your formal declaration of intention for each other. Please join me.
Already there.
Bride and groom look into each other's eyes while officiant yes,
don't kill him.
Jesse Scott, you choose Rebecca Joanne McGaw to be your wife, to have and to hold from this day forward for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do you part?
I absolutely do.
Rebecca Joanne McGaw, do you choose Jesse Scott Hughes to be your husband, to have and to hold from this day forward for better or worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, till death do you part?
I do.
Love is patient and kind. Love does not envy or boast. It is not arrogant or rude. It does not insist on its own way. It is not irritable or resentful. It does not rejoice at wrongdoing, but rejoices with the truth. Love bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, and endures all things.
I just want to start by saying I'm the luckiest woman in the world.
It's okay.
It's all good.
You make me cry, it's going to be awkward for me too.
Me too, don't do that.
Since we've started out, this has been something rare, incomparable to anything I've known. There have been so many firsts. The first time I've ever had no doubts. The first time I know I can fall and will always be caught. And the first time I felt a trust like ours and had no need to hide any part of myself. The first love that never wavers. I will be there with you and for you, for all of the in-between. Even more, I promise to want you for all my lasts. The last face I see every day for the rest of my life. The last thought in my head at night. And most of all, the last person I fall in love with until my last breath and evermore.
Not for you. I even brought my readers. I know how much you like that. Rebecca, I love you. You're amazing. I'm so proud to be part of your life. There's a lot of emotion and intent that I was trying to fit into here, but it all seemed to revolve around those same three themes. That I love you, that you are amazing, and that I'm so glad that we're right here today. As for the rest of those intentions, I look forward to spending the rest of my days showing you just how much you mean to me. For now, though, let me move on to some simple promises that I know I can keep. I'll strive to keep my head in the present while looking forward to the future, because living with you now is just as important as what's to come. I vow to always try and appreciate our simple times, making coffee for each other, drinking tea at the beach, innumerable pizza dates, and even just sitting on the couch watching an episode of The Impractical Jokers for the 1,000th time. I pledge to do my best to help realize our dreams, whether those dreams are revisiting something old or making something new. I will do my very best to listen, to hear your worries and soothe your pains. More importantly, to be your cheerleader in all things. Pom-pom's optional. And you also have my word from the deepest places in my heart that I will always keep trying to be the best partner I can be. I love you, and you're amazing, and I'm so glad I get to be your husband.
Now, having this kind of love in your hearts for one another, you have chosen to exchange rings as the sign and seal of the promises you are making to one another today. The wedding ring serves as a symbol of the promise you have just spoken. It is the outward and visible sign of an inward and invisible love that binds your heart together. Wear them as a sign of love that exists between you, the love that now your heart enfolds and the words express. Larry. Thank you. Okay, you need that one. Jesse, please take your ring and place it upon the ring of finger of Rebecca's left hand.
This one, right?
Yes.
Okay.
And holding her hand in yours, please repeat this promise to Rebecca, saying after me. Rebecca,
with this ring, I thee wed.
As a symbol
of my never-ending love and devotion.
I promise to honor and cherish you.
And be your devoted husband.
For as long as we both shall live. Rebecca, will you please take this ring and place it upon the ring finger of Jesse's left hand?
Yeah.
And holding his hand in yours, please repeat the promise to Jesse, saying after me. Jesse. With this ring I thee wed. As a symbol of my never-ending love and devotion. I promise to honor and cherish you. And be your devoted wife for as long as we both shall live. Jesse and Rebecca, today, your wedding day is one more brief moment in time, and although your vows have been spoken in a matter of minutes, they are promises that will last a lifetime. When you leave this ceremony today, you will be better people because of each other. Because of your love and trust for one another, your lives are fulfilled and you are at a new beginning. Take these promises made to one another today and carry them with you in your hearts, always. I would like to leave this thought with both of you. Jesse, don't stop dating your wife, and Rebecca, don't never stop flirting with your husband. Pronouncement of marriage. For as much as Jesse and Rebecca have consented together in holy wedlock and have witnessed the same before these witnesses, and thereto have pledged their faithfulness each to the other, and have pledged the same by giving and receiving of the rings, by the authority vested in me as a minister of the gospel and a notary republic, according to the laws of the state of Florida, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Those whom God have joined together, let no man put asunder. Jesse, you may kiss the bride.
I've been waiting to do this.
Once they walk out of here, we are going to be going over there for food.
As a storm blows through, and I need you.
Ooh, I get to hug the... You don't fall down.
I know.
Ma'am, you did good.
No, I love you.
I love you too. And you're doing good with all these people.
Yeah.
I know. So I was like...
One, two, three!
Yeah! There's more here than what we're seeing. A divine conspiracy. And you, an angel lovely, could somehow fall from me. Always be love's great martyr, and I'll be the flattered fool, and I need you. Yeah, God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days of doubt, and for when I think I lost my way, there are no words here left to say. Your name.
name and it's colder than you. Oh, well, from the barrio, you feel the rhythm on the radio and feel the turning of the world so soft and slow, turning you round. And if you shout, this life's been good enough, I would give my world to lift you up. I would change my life to better suit your mood. You're so smooth, just like the ocean under the moon. Same as the emotion I get from you. Got the kind of love and I can be so smooth. Give me your heart, make it real, forget about it. And if you said this life ain't good enough, give my word to lift you up, I could change my life to better suit your mood. Cause you're so smooth, just like the ocean under the moon. Same as the emotion I get from you. You've got this kind of love and it can be so smooth. Give me your heart, make it real, forget about it. It's don't forget about it. No, 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 we won't forget about it. No, 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 forget about it.
Got 12 ounces, a good truck's got maybe 300,000. You only get so much until it's gone. Duracell's in a mag light, a needle drop on a 45, are the kind of things that only last so long. When the new wears off and they get to getting old, sooner or later, time's gonna take its toll. They say nothing lasts forever, but they ain't seen us together or the way the moonlight dances in your eyes.
Camera good. Okay, okay, let's get her in there. Oh, we got another one. Okay, good.
Hey, Jesse. Hey, Rebecca. Thanks. Thanks for the wedding. It was amazing. The food was delicious. Ceremony was gorgeous. Appreciate everything. And thanks for getting all these people who used to live here to come back.
You both know how much I love y'all. And Jesse, I'm so happy to be here on this day for you on your wedding day. And we all love you so very much. And we're so happy for you. And may you both have just a long life together of memories and joy and all the adventures you can handle.
Hi, Jesse and Rebecca. Thank you so much for inviting us to your wedding. I remember Jesse as being the one who always went on the walkabouts on the parties, and you wouldn't see him for hours. And he would either be alone or he would be with somebody, and he was just thinking and pondering life, and he would always come back and talk about what he thought about. And I also remember distinctly going through a bad breakup and Jesse inviting me over to his house and cooking for me and consoling me and talking me through it. So I just consider him to be this very thoughtful, intentional person. And so I can only imagine a person like that, who they picked to share their life with. So Rebecca, I'm sure you're an amazing person and I'm so happy for the both of you to share your life together.
Jesse and Rebecca, thank you so much for the honor of inviting us to share in this celebration with you guys. You put together a beautiful ceremony, which just to me tells me that you guys are gonna put together a beautiful life together. And I wish you the best in every endeavor, and I'm sure you guys are going to be fantastic together. Thank you.
Congratulations, Jesse and Rebecca. Thank you for inviting us. I remember when I first met Jesse, I was thinking, how do I grow up to be that cool? and she seems awesome. Congratulations.
Hey, Jesse and Rebecca. I'm so excited to get to know Rebecca better because Jesse is one of the sweetest, most caring people I've ever met. And he just has the hugest heart. So I can only imagine what he found in you and what an amazing couple you'll be. And I think you'll have a beautiful marriage. And I'm so excited to be here and celebrate you. I love you, Daddy-O.
Hey, give it up for Larry. I had the most delicious pina colada. I think that's what it was, but it was good. It was good. All right, please, everybody, attention, if you would, to the maid of honor.
Hello, everyone.
Hello.
My name is Jamie Jo, and I have the pleasure of being Rebecca's maid of honor, or as I like to call it, her therapist, her problem solver, and the human tissue dispenser. And most importantly, which is the best part of all, her best friend. I have known Rebecca for approximately 8 years. We met at a local pool hall where I was running OPT, my free poker league. Just a quick overview for the ones that don't know, OPT is a free poker league where you get to play Texas Hold'em, no limit, poker. I pride myself on the fact that my league is more than a poker league. We are a big family. Actually, thank you. Actually, a few members of the bridal party, along with many guests here today, are part of the league.
Yes, ma'am.
I feel so blessed that God brought us together that night. I not only found my best friend, but gained another family, the McGaws. I mean, come on, Diana calls me every family member's name besides my own. So they say I'm officially a part of the family.
Absolutely.
I am honored and feel so blessed to be part of Rebecca's life and to be her maid of honor. Rebecca is one special person that deserves to be loved by someone special. And I'm delighted to say that person's Jesse. Jesse is absolutely perfect for Rebecca. They both complement each other so well.
Amen.
I remember the day that Rebecca told me she was going on their first date with him and how he was coming down from Gainesville. I told Rebecca that Mandy, a good friend of ours, and I were going too. We had to make sure he wasn't a serial killer. Obviously he wasn't, thank God. They hit it off and have been inseparable ever since. I've had the privilege of getting to know Jesse these past few years, and I'm so thankful to know my best friend is in good hands. He is caring, has a big heart, and overall a great person. Anyone can take one look at them together and see that they are a perfect example of meant to be. I'm honored that you both have not only chosen me to be a significant part of your day, but also a significant person in your lives. I'm excited to watch you to enjoy this new chapter in your lives as a married couple. I love you both very much. Everyone would raise their glass. Here's to love, laughter, and happy ever after. Rebecca and Jesse Hughes. Love you.
Every bit of that was true.
Absolutely. I'm looking for the best man to come on up.
That'll be Larry.
The best man and the best bartender, too.
So the bar is temporarily closed. Actually, no, the bar is self-serve.
Except for when you make it old-fashioned.
Those are pretty. And actually, I have some old-fashioned, so a little bit of Long Island iced tea over there if anybody wants that. Whew, it's been a hot day. Well, first off, I'm Larry. I've known Jesse for, actually, the thing is I'm so old, I don't remember when we first met. Like, how many years ago was it?
Like 2002.
So that's like almost 20, oh my God, we're old. That's like 22 years.
You didn't see me doing my vows with readers, right?
that is true. So I've known Jesse for a very long time. We've had all sorts of adventures, from driving around in the coolest car in Gainesville, mopping weird bathrooms late at night on a Wednesday night, gaming with weird people. We have a lot of friends here from that, so we had lots of adventure. Jesse was also the host to my niece one time. She did an internship here in Gainesville. I was out of town, so it was my niece and Jesse.
And afterwards, this is long before you came along, no competition here. But after she was done, my mom was like, that Jesse guy is so sweet. He's the nicest guy ever. If your father ever dies, honestly, it was like, no, Mom. So first off, thank you for taking Jesse out of I don't want to be called, there's no way I would ever call him dad. So thank you so much. So I'm actually really glad you got married just so my mom has lost interest in you. And she doesn't kill my father to do this, so thank you very much. I also remember the very first time, because I travel a lot, so I'm home very rarely, so I'm in and out. The very first time I met Rebecca, everyone knows she's very outgoing, hyper-talkative, super active. And so when I got back...
Wait, you're talking about Rebecca?
So when I got back, got home from traveling, and I was like, who is this weird girl who's wearing a hoodie and is under the covers on the couch? I don't even know what she looks like, but she's here with Jesse. I guess this might be okay. And it took about 3 weeks before I actually could see her face. It was like, holy cow. But I was like, she's a real person. Because I was concerned, like some people, there was a stalker, mass murderer, come up from Ocala. Luckily, actually, first off, thank you for not wearing a hoodie. It's too hot outside because, sweet summer child, you're gorgeous.
It's never too hot for a hoodie.
That's true. So I'm glad that you were able to come out. And that was the one of the very positive things that I learned from living with Jesse while you guys were together is you actually did compliment each other quite well. Because you are, I'm not going to get into weaknesses and strengths, but you complement each other perfect. Like your yep. strengths complement yep. his weaknesses and vice versa. And that's a perfect coupling.
Yes.
Also, to this day, I eat more vegetarian.
Yeah.
So, although I'm not part of this relationship, I feel like I've kind of bonded a little bit because I'm eating a lot more rice and good old Korean food, so it's good times.
Yeah, I hear you.
So I am very thankful that you guys came together today, and it was a beautiful ceremony. I'm proud to have been selected as your best man. I think it's a wonderful opportunity for both of you. You're going to go far. I hope, I'm not going to wish all that foo-foo stuff, I'm just going to hope you guys knock boots into your 80s. So if you can do that, everything is good.
That's young.
So thank you very much. Let's all raise our drinks up to a fabulous wedding ceremony and a fabulous couple. Rock on, and you are not allowed to see my mom.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, we're gonna. I know it's everything's been pretty sweet, but there's also something very tasty and sweet over here. So we're gonna do the cake cutting. If we could have Jesse and Rebecca come on over here, and then everybody gather around, nice and close, so we can see what's gonna happen.
A little bit.
matter what I do. So I'm saving this for you. This seems to be the last piece there is. And you haven't had the chance yet to taste this. Fragments of a life you shouldn't miss. Seems to matter what I say. So I'll hold my tongue at bay. And rather use my mouth to kiss your frown away. So your doubts no longer darken your day. And you can hold your head up high, come what may. So please remember that I'm going to follow through all the way. Seems to matter where I go. And I will always let you know. Place where I am, well, it's never far. And you know you're not alone. Don't be alarmed, find you no matter where you are. So please remember that I'm going to follow through all the way. It's all I can do. Take the fall for you. Cause I will soar when I lay down with you. Give my all for you. I'm going to follow through all the way.
We got some questions coming up real soon.
When you think it's true of you, you hold up your own shoe. Is that right, Jesse? Alright, so if it's true, Jesse, just to demonstrate, if Jesse thinks that who has the better beautiful dark hair, he's going to put up his wife's shoe. Okay? But if I ask him who has the better mustache, you hesitated too long on that one. I've never seen these questions before, but they're going to vote, and if it's true of him, like who's the most handsome guy you've ever seen, she's going to put up his shoe, right? And who's there we go. Are you ready? So, first question, who planned the first date? They both took the same amount of time. They both realized it was them together. Good, this is good. Right. We're on the same page. Right. We're on the same foot. All right. Number two, who's the better cook? Consensus. This is good. Number three, who is better at keeping surprises?
Jesse.
She didn't say so. Okay.
She's undecided.
Number four, who said I love you first?
Yeah. That's that one, right?
Yeah, he knew. Five, who is more likely to get sunburned? She
said
didn't put up her shoe. She figured she had the hoodie on, she'd be safe.
I was just dry skin to
aside from hoodie, okay. All right, number six. Who's more likely to cry during a sad movie? Seven, who is more likely to be running late?
Eight,
who will be in charge of the TV remote?
That's my friend too! I don't want
trust, there's trust there, that's good. She held it as high as she could. She's counting on you. All right, who is most likely to wake up grumpy? All right. Who is messier? All right, number 11. I don't know the answer to this one. Who has the longest hair?
Barely.
Okay. She agrees. All right. Number 11. We're halfway there. Excuse me, 12. Who has the better shower singing voice? That's it. You appreciate each other's voices. Now, who makes the better breakfast?
You're wonderful.
French
toast versus scrambled eggs.
All right, 14. Who is the better kisser?
She said both. She said you.
Who is funnier?
He's smart, man. He said her.
There we go. Who is the most patient?
There you go.
Must be one of your.
Listen,
why does
she
like
agree with the groom too?
Who's the first to apologize? Who gives the better massage? Who is faster at responding to a text?
I feel like we are pretty good. He said you.
We got a winner.
Who is the best gift giver?
Definitely Rebecca.
They agreed on that one. Who would be the better drag queen? Number 22. Who steals the covers?
They agree on that one.
And the last question is a good one. It's so good. Who can't imagine life without the other?
That's
the right answer.
That's awesome.
All right, give it up for the Hughes. You guys ready to dance?
Yeah!
I'm taking requests. Get going then.
I'm
new, the Casper Slide Part 2, featuring the Platinum Band, and this time, we're gonna get funky.
this watch.
Just friends, but friends don't know that it tastes like. We got to do it again. machine man. Put your pants through. I need something big enough to take your ass to. Swag on them even when you drag casual. Now they is all over the world. Don't give a 100 years not there. When I pull up on Saturday, you fan me, man. I'm looking like your leg. I used to swear for you. Your sweat that isn't for your hair, man. I don't watch the jail watch you. Hand wait for you. Salute that you did pimp. Not many women here. If you did pimp, I'm a nice guy, but I'm getting confused.
Smell wine and cheap perfume.
yourself, walk here by yourself. To the right, to the right, to the right, the right, the right. To the left, to the left, to the left, the left, the left. Now kick, now kick, now kick, now kick, now walk here by yourself. Walk here by yourself and do the Cupid shuffle. Now let me see you do the Cupid shuffle. Now let me see you do the Cupid shuffle. Your boy Cupid, see your feet are out of deep. It's a bet on the track.
Rebecca and Jesse, this is Dominic. I know you don't know me, but I'm dating Jess here, even though, you know, she gets all blushy about it. We just wanted to tell you guys congratulations, and we hope you guys have a wonderful time. And now you know it's real because she only flicks off the people she loves. Congratulations, guys.
Say congratulations.
Congratulations. Love you guys.
Because I give you all of me, and you give me all. How many times do I have to tell you? Even when you're crying, you're beautiful too. The world is beating you down, around, through every mood. You're my downfall, you're my muse, my worst distraction, my rhythm and blues. I can't stop singing, it's ringing in my
wedding song.
I've known Jesse and Rebecca for a while. I knew Rebecca back playing poker for many, many years, and I've seen her grow since she met Jesse and what they have together. I think it's fantastic. I hope and pray that it lasts for quite a long time.
Hey guys, just want to say I love you and congratulations.
Hey Rebecca and Jesse, I can tell for the first time that I saw you two together that Jesse, you brought light to her eyes, and you guys are a great couple, and I wish you many happy years together. Good luck. Take care.
I've been a walking heartache. I've made a mess of me. The person that I've been lately ain't who I wanna be. But you stay here right beside me and watch as the storm blows through, and I need you. 'Cause God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days. Divine conspiracy that you, an angel lovely, could somehow fall for me. You'll always be love's great martyr, and I'll be the flattered fool. God gave me you for the ups and downs. God gave me you for the days of doubt.
Down in 5, the smell of your perfume is floating down the stairs. You're fixing up your hair like you do.
I know that I'll be a mess the second that I see you, but you won't be surprised. It happens every time, it's nothing new.
It's always on a night like tonight. Thank God you can read my mind.
'Cause when you look at me with those eyes,
I'm speaking.
watching you is all that I can do. And I'm speechless. You already know that you're my weakness. After all this time, I'm just as nervous. Every time you walk into the room, I'm speechless. It started when you said hello. Just did something to me. And I've been in a daze ever since the day that we met. You took the breath out of my lungs, can't even fight it. And all of the words out of my mouth without even trying. And I'm speechless. Staring at you standing there in that dress. What it's doing to me ain't a secret. 'Cause watching you is all that I can do. And I'm speechless. You already know that you're my weakness. After all this time, I'm just as nervous. Every time you walk into the room, I'm speechless. Speechless.
Standing there in that dress.
Oh, babe.
Girl, it ain't a secret. 'Cause watching you is all that I can do. Oh, 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 I'm speechless.
Speechless.
You already know that you're my weakness. After all this time, I'm just as nervous. Every time you walk into the room.
Up the money, I just never could quite tell you no. Just like when you were leaving Amarillo, take that new job in Tennessee, and I quit mine so we could be together. I can't forget the way you looked at me. Just to see you smile, I'd do anything that you wanted me to. When all is said and done, I never count the cost. It's worth all that's lost. Just to see you smile. You said time was all you really needed. I walked away and let you have your space. All leaving didn't hurt me near as badly as the tears I saw rolling down your face. And yesterday I knew just what you wanted when you came walking up to me with him. I told you that I was happy for you, and given the chance I'd lie again. Just to see you smile, I'd do anything that you wanted me to. When all is said and done, I never count the cost. It's worth
much lost just to see you smile.
Just to